Good afternoon, 47. Your destination is the annual Global Innovation Motor Race in Miami, Florida. After analyzing the data from Reynard's computer, the case is clear. The Providence defectors are Robert and Sierra Knox, head of robotics developer Kronstadt Industries. A visionary inventor and technological innovator, Robert Knox has spearheaded Kronstadt Industries to the bleeding edge of technological development. His equally brilliant daughter, Sierra, is not only a financial wizard, but also a fiercely competitive race car driver with a fiery temper to match. Kronstadt enjoys enormous popularity with global consumers. However, few are aware that the company is also one of the world's leading suppliers of next-gen military tech. Last year, despotic ruler Jin Po employed prototype Kronstadt drones against peaceful civilian protesters in the now infamous Tungyan Valley incident. And although it has yet to be proven, there is little doubt that the Knoxes personally brokered the deal, making them complicit in a war crime. It is unclear why the Knoxes would betray their masters, but likely, the fear of being next on the Shadow Client's hit list has pressured them to cut a deal with the enemy. Undoubtedly, with Kronstadt Industries on their side, the militia will increase their attacks tenfold, and so our contract obligates us to retire Robert and Sierra Knox and contain the damage they may inflict on Providence. I will leave you to prepare. Welcome to Miami, 47. The innovation race is on its last day, and it is down to the wire. Thousands of eager fans are gathered for the final laps of this unexpectedly close race. Sierra Knox is expertly piloting her red Kronstadt car. Her father, Robert Knox, roams the nearby expo building where Kronstadt is showcasing its new prototype car. The Kronstadt RK Mark III has seen fierce competition from the Chinese Kowloon Heavy Industries new racer. Moses Lee, CEO of Kowloon, has taken a dominant lead and looks invincible. Sierra Knox will need to risk it all if she wants to win for the third year in a row. The stakes are as high as they can get.
Thank you. officer, and the wife, and the children.
Jimmy, it's me. I'm here now.
Ready to meet up with Sierra Knox.
What?
No.
Can't move around with them. We need to get the replacement pressure valve, so I literally duct taped everything together just now. You could fry everyone on stage if the pressure gets too high.
But Rudder asked me to test it.
If he asks, just tell him I've got it under control. Whatever you do, don't touch the setup.
Okay, gotcha.
Maxwell Rudder, the race chief coordinator, is worried that the powerful new pyrotechnics system connected to the victory podium is not exactly tamper-proof. Sabotaging it could have devastating consequences. Well, what are you waiting for?
That endurance race is all about getting your car to cover as many miles as possible, no matter how burned out or beat up it may be.
So did Dr. Sorensen manage to get Sierra Knox's phone number?
I heard him arguing with that Kronstadt lawyer earlier.
No, didn't have any luck. What's he done with that?
Getting some miles under the hood. It's as much about the car's stamina and technology as it is about the driver's tech.
Hey,
Yeah, Trevor Jones just wants to put California behind him and get on him and stay in the race for as long as possible, and then who knows what might happen.
The race is over. Sierra will be coming off the track any time now. I like your thinking, 47. With the safety off, someone could make the podium pyrotechnics fire up rather explosively.
Safe to say that this year's winner is a bit of a surprise winner to many of us. While they certainly weren't the favorites, they somehow managed to get to the top of the ladder over the course of these 3 days, which have seen a staggering number of accidents and related incidents. So, without further ado, I present to you Miss Sierra Knox of Team Kronstadt. Come on up here, Miss Knox.
Down. Next up, Robert Knox.
I can assure you that we'll give you all the information we can get as soon as it comes in. April rush up to the podium. Let me tell you this. We have the best medics in the country. The best of the best. Oh my, what a shocking ending to a dramatic race here in Miami.
Sierra will be coming off the track any time now.
Kronstadt Industries wishes you and your family a wonderful day of the races. Don't forget to visit the website today and join Sierra and and the team. Kronstadt Industries, a better
senior race official here at the Miami Global Innovation Race. The race is now officially over, and it's time to hand out the trophy to the winner. I think it is safe to say that this year's winner is a bit of a surprise winner to many of us. While they certainly weren't the favorites, they somehow managed to get to the top of the ladder over the course of these 3 days, which have seen a staggering number of accidents and inflated incidents. So, without further ado, I present to you Miss Sierra Knox of Team Prime. Come on up here, Miss Knox.
Sierra will be coming off the track any time now. That's one of the Kronstadt mechanics, but he's away from the pit. I wonder what he's up to.
Don't settle for second best. Guardian Tires. Driver's choice.
Listen, Miller, I don't care about your problems, all right? I made it clear this morning that if things didn't change, I'd be off the Kronstadt team. Later, I have to listen to Knox berate my skills as a mechanic because the roll cage interferes with the radio signal from Sierra's suit.
Let's get those Magnum Dom Perignon bottles.
I know you're a man. I don't give a rat's ass about it. Double my salary for the entire week, and I'll come back in case Sierra decides to use that last pit stop. Well, if you decide otherwise, I'll be down by the paddock. Best of luck, Grace.
For sure.
Hey, you know you can't sleep in there.
Huh?
I...
Hmm.
So,
the race is over and Sierra won. We should expect her to head towards the podium area for the winning ceremony.
Absolutely.
Hi there, mechanic.
Buckaroo.
Thank you.
and off.
Damned. He showed up. Moses Lee actually grew a pair and arrived just in time for the chili immolation challenge. Are you ready to do some crying, Lee? I'll see you inside, my boy. This is gonna hurt.
Down. Next up, Robert Knox.
seats here.
Really? I had no idea it was that good.
Oh, it's good. It's real good. I mean, I get cravings if I don't come down here to eat once or twice per week. At one point, when I worked near here, I ate lunch here every day.
But Robert Knox? He's like a big shot billionaire.
It's true. I was standing in line behind him yesterday. He talked about how he loves this place to death.
It seems Robert Knox paid several visits to a Bayside area food stand yesterday. The vendor, known as Florida Man, sells extremely addictive food, so we should expect Knox to return. Maybe this is a way to catch Knox away from his office.
Yo, Em, it's me.
Look, I need the crystal.
Right? Well, I can't very well work without it, can I now? Dressed as what? Speak up, woman. What?
Good show, 47. Now stick around. Once the word spreads, Knox won't be long.
Hello. Why don't you give this a try?
Thank you kindly.
It's got a little kick to it.
Robert Knox is on the move. If I'm not mistaken, he's heading down to the Bayside food stand selling coconut balls.
Hi there. Care for a taste?
No.
It's what I do. Pardon me. Can I offer you a little treat?
No, way!
Hi. You want to try something different?
Huh? Thank you!
Anytime.
Is enough to trigger a massive rush of dopamine. I don't know what he's putting in his food, but I've sure got the munchies.
Excuse me. Care for a snack?
So, what's good?
Everything's to die for, Mr. Knox.
Excellent. Maybe one of these. Mm. Oh, shit.
Both targets down. Well done, 47. Head for an exit, and we'll speak again soon. Show 47. Now stick around. Once the word spreads,
excuse me,
Knox won't
you
be
You should
long.
Try this. It really is to die for.
Forty-seven, Robert Knox is on the move. If I'm not mistaken, he's heading down to the Bayside food stand selling coconut balls.
Excuse me. Care for a snack?
Uh-oh. Thanks.
My pleasure. Wrap your lips around this.
What?
You're welcome. you should try this.
Hmm? Yes, thanks.
No, thank you. Who wants a taste? You? Go ahead.
Oh, no way!
Mmm, smell alone is enough to trigger a massive rush of dopamine. I don't know what he's putting in his food, but I've sure got the munchies.
Hello. Can I tempt you with a little snack?
So, what's good?
Everything's to die for, Mr. Knox.
Excellent. Maybe one of these.
See a doctor now.
Both targets down. Well done, 47. Head for an exit, and we'll speak again soon.
Clear here. Yeah, okay. I don't see anything suspicious either.
You're a lifesaver. I thought I was going to have to mug a diabetic or something to get this. Time to cook up some magic.
Howdy, partner.
Greetings, sir.
What the?
Ladies and gentlemen, get your quick lunch over here. Big ass portions and dirt cheap.
Thanks a lot.
Robert Knox is on the move. If I'm not mistaken, he's heading down to the Bayside food stand selling coconut balls.
Hey, I think you left this behind.
Want to check it out?
Yes, yeah.
What? Thank you kindly.
What's all the buzz about? There's nothing here. Look, nothing.
Right.
That's it, ladies and gentlemen. Get your quick lunch over here. Big-ass portions and dirt cheap. Not Taco Tuesday, but these coconut balls...
Much appreciated.
Sales.
Thank you.
That is Robert Knox. Genius inventor, black markets weapons dealer, and Providence defector.
Trigger a massive rush of dopamine. What he's putting in his food, but I've sure got the munchies. Let me just grab one of these. Ah, that's the ticket. Absolute perfection. That was superb, my good man. I'll be back for more in a little while. Just need to stretch my legs. Keep it coming.
Yeah, get your bottom over here, ladies and gents. You want some real Florida special instead of those tacos?
Thumbs up.
You gotta be kidding me.
Sir, you can't leave that here.
Excuse me?
Both targets down. Well done, 47. Head for an exit, and we'll speak again soon.
Berlin. Shanghai. Montreal. We're bleeding operatives. Panic is spreading, and now we are axing our own?
Knox was a traitor. He would have caused incalculable damage.
And he won't be the last. This is exactly what the enemy wants. We need to fight the sickness, not the symptom.
And I have just the tool for the job.
Right. The Burnwood woman. Eric Soders warned you about her, didn't he? The Crusader.
I can handle Miss Burnwood. Everyone hates power until you offer them some.
And you ought to know.
ICA speaks the enemy.
And once we don't?
We'll cross that bridge when we get there.
Fact remains, we are shadowboxing. We need to know who we are up against.
I was getting to that. His name is Lucas Gray. The late Mr. Cobb's head of security. Cobb was ground zero, first of our operatives to die. It had to be one of his staff, someone with military training and access to the plane.
Grasping at straws.
Gray is a mercenary, a veteran of every backwater tragedy you've ever ignored on the 5 o'clock news. Chechnya, Sierra Leone, the list goes on, but before 89, nothing. No records of any kind.
Ah, come on. CIA, KGB, plenty of spies went dark.
After the curtain was lifted, I cast a very wide net. Lucas Gray simply does not exist.
If you're all quite done wetting yourselves with excitement, I couldn't give two shits where he came from. I only want to know one thing.
How does he know about us?
I swear to God, this hearts and flowers crap will get us both killed. Can't you see? Your so-called friend is working for them now. He's not the man you knew.
This is his fight too, Olivia.
Even if he doesn't realize it. Like it or not, 47 is our last and only lead on the partners. He needs to remember.
He's coming for us. And unlike you, he won't hesitate.
Just get me inside. Rico, I need a favor.